Okay. Today we will continue with the integrations. It's a 5.4. Last week we have done indefinite integrals. It's 5.3, and this week I will teach you on integration using U substitutes. So 5.4. Integration using U substitutes. Integration using U substitutions. Okay, we go direct to the example here. So if you have a case like this, so let's say I want to integrate 5x plus 3 raised 2 dx. I want to integrate this function. Okay. So this you can use U substitute. And we can simplify this thing and let's say we put let u is equal to 5x plus by 3. So if you have u is equal to 5x plus by 3, so I want to, so if I substitute into this part, we get u. So u is 5x plus 3, so here is u raised 2 dx. But if we integrate this here, we integrate this one, this function, we integrate with respect to x. So we will get x u raised 2. But if you change this in term of u, dx you have to change in term of du. So dx in term of du, if I differentiate this one, we get du dx. I differentiate this one, du dx. The basic rule of division is du dx is equal to 5 plus by 0. So mean to say, if I solve this one, so this one is written as dx or du is equal to 5 dx. In other words, dx is equal to du over 5. So dx is du over 5. I put inside here and get u raised 2 dx is du over 5. So now we have u and we have u square and du here. So this can, you can integrate here with respect to u. So if I integrate with respect to u here, I have u raised 3 over 3 multiplied by 5 plus by c. This is my answer. Then this can be written as, so once you get the answer here, then you can substitute mu is equal to, u is equal to x, 5x plus by 3 to into this function, you get 5x plus 3 raised 3 over 15 plus by c. This is your final answer for method of integration using U substitution. Okay, let's say I have one more example here. Let's say I have want to integrate the integration of 2x plus by 4 plus by 3, sorry, plus by 3 raise 4 dx. Want to integrate this one. So for this case you can use a u substitution, let u is equal to 2x plus by 3. So both there become integration of, because of u is 2x plus by 3, you have u raised 4 dx. Now dx here you have to change the 2 into du. So from here we get, if I differentiate here, I have du dx equal to 2x raised 0 plus by 0. So in other words, du is equal to 2 dx, dx is equal to du over 2. Okay. So dx is du over 2, so here become u raised 4, dx is du over 2. So we integrate in respect to u, we have u by the basic formula, u raised 4 plus 1 is 5 over 5 multiplied by 2 plus by c. So this will give me an answer of u raised 5 over 10 plus c. Then I substitute again 3 raised 5 over 10 x plus 3 raised 5 over 10 plus by c. These are how we solve the integration there using u substitution. Then we go to example 5.6. Example 5.6. Example 5.6. I have here, I want to integrate, I want to use u substitution of this one. A, first one, A is equal to, I want to find integration of 1 over x. So here, if you integrate here, you don't have to use, the u substitution, because of these are a straightforward integrations. So this will give you the answer of the integration of 1 over x is log exponent x plus by c. These are direct integration. You don't have to use u substitution. Okay, let's say I have one more example here. So I have 1 over x minus by 2 dx. So in this case, I want to use u substitutions. So I put that u equal to x minus by 2. So this thing become integration of 1 over u dx. Now I have to convert, I have to change dx into du. So from here we have du dx is equal to 1 minus by 0, or du equal to dx. So in other words, du is equal to dx, so I can put here as a 1 over u du. Now the integration of 1 over u du, we apply the same method here. So if I have 1 over x dx, the integration there is a log exponent x plus by c. So for this case, the integration here is a log exponent u plus by c. Then you can, again, you can substitute u equal to x minus by 2. So here become log x minus by 2, because of u is equal to x minus by 2 plus by c. This is how we solve the integration by substitution. Now, another technique for integration is integration by part. Integration by part, using integration 5.5. The integration using Now, the general formula for integration by part is the integration of u dv equal to uv minus by v du. So, try we take one example here. If I have here, I want to find, let's say I want to find x sine x dx. So, if I compare this one, u dv is equal to uv minus v du. So, here, I can put here x here as a u, and dv, this one is equal to, dv is equal to sine x dx. So, here it is. So, let u is equal to x, and dv is equal to dv is equal to sine x dx. Okay. So if you have u is equal to x, du dx is equal to 1, isn't it? Du dx. For this case, du dx is equal to 1. Or in other words, du is equal to dx multiplied by 1. Du is equal to du is equal to dx, or du is equal to du is equal to dx multiplied by 1. Okay. Now, if we have if we have dv is equal to sine x dx, I want to find v. So to find v here, because of the formula here involved u and v, we know that dv is equal to sine x dx. So if I want to find v here, I need to integrate sine x dx. I need to integrate sine x dx. So to find v here, the integration of dv, the integration of dv is equal to v. And if you integrate this one, we need to integrate this one. So, integration of dv equal to the integration of, so dv is equal to sine x dx. So, to find v, you integrate dv. So, the integration of dv, so this part you need to integrate sine x dx. Now, the integration of sine x dx, if you refer to the formula, so this is equal to, so integration of dv is equal to v, and the integration of sine x dx is equal to negative cos x. This you can refer to the previous formula that I've given to you. So now v is equal to negative cos x. So we have v here, we have u here, u is equal to x, and then we have du is equal to dx, then three things here you have, then you can substitute into this formula because of the integration of that one. So the integration of, we use integration by part, integration of x sine x dx. So we use this formula because of, we assume that we assume that u is equal to x, dv is equal to sine x dx. So this become uv minus by vdu by applying the above formula. So u is equal to x, and v is equal to negative cos x minus by your v is equal to negative cos x, and du is equal to dx. So this can be written as negative cos x multiplied by x is negative x cos x. So negative become positive integration of cos x dx. The integration of cos x is equal to sine x. So the integration of cos x is equal to sin x. Here become negative x cos x. The integration of cos x, if you refer to the previous formula, become plus by sin x plus by c. This is the final answer for the integration by pi. Okay? Example here. And the last part is the integration of partial fractions technique. Partial fraction techniques. So integration using partial fraction techniques. Now, so this integration involves a fraction, and the equation is about fractions. So I have a fraction here, the function term of fraction here. I have, let's say I have example here. I have x plus 8, the fraction over, if you find this case, you have this case, you have x squared plus by x minus by 2. It's a quite, you cannot simply solve, you cannot simply integrate. You see, you have to, this is a little fraction here, so I want to find the integration. Yeah, so if you find this is a case, okay, we have a fraction here, so you have to use a partial fraction technique. So first of all, I need to factorize the denominator here. So you need to factorize the denominator here. So if I factorize this denominator, I get top here is still x plus 8. So if you factorize this thing, you get x plus 2, x minus by 1. You can refer to your basic formula for factorization. So if you factorize this one, you get x plus 2 divided by x plus 1 dx. So we have in term of factorize here, so we can use a partial fraction. So to solve this one, you can put here, you can write this in term of you can write this in term of x plus 8 over x plus 2 x plus minus 1 dx is equal to, you can just put a over x plus 2 plus by b over x minus 1 dx. If I integrate this function, if we refer to the basic formula, the integration of a fraction 1 over x is equal to log exponent x. So if I have the integration of a over x plus 2 dx, this will give me a log exponent x plus 2. Okay, so but we need to solve we need to find a and b first before we can proceed to the integration here. So we need to find a and b. Okay? We need to find a and b because of once you simplify in terms of the fraction here, this is quite easy to solve because of we use this rule. 1 over something is equal to log x plus 2, log exponent of x plus 2. Okay. So if I have a here over x plus 2, so dx is a log exponent of x plus 2. So for this case, I need to find a and b. Okay, I need to find a and b. To find a and b here, we can solve like this. So because of the numerator here is x plus a. So if you solve this one, so this one we get, so a over x plus 2 plus by b over x plus 1 is equal to, so if I solve here, I will get a x minus 1 plus by b x plus 2, this is equal to x plus 8. Okay. You cross product here. So a x plus minus 1 and b x plus 2 is equal to the denominator, the numerator, okay? So x plus 8. So if I solve this one, I get a x minus by a plus by b x plus by 2b is equal to a x plus by 8. Okay, I group x and x, and then a and b here, we have ax plus by bx minus by a plus by 2b equal to x plus by 8. So in other words, I can put here is a x a plus by b minus by a plus by 2b. So here we have x here, and this part, so here is equal to x plus 8. Here is x plus by 8, x plus by 8, and here is x plus by 8. So you can see here is x a plus b, and the other part is negative a plus by 2b. So this is the same as this one, and this part is this part. So in other words, x a plus b I can put as equal to x, then the other one is negative a plus by 2b is equal to 8. So if I compare here we've got 1 here, so a plus b equal to 1 and negative a plus by 2b is equal to 8. Now, if you solve this one, let's say here is number 1 and here is number 2, equation number 1 and equation number 2. If you solve this one, if you add these two, equation 1 plus by equation 2, a plus by negative a is 0, b plus by 2b is equal to 3b, 1 plus by a is equal to 9. So, in other words, b is equal to 9 divided by 3 is equal to 3. B is equal to 3. So when B is equal to 3, A is equal to negative 2. So if you substitute B equal to 3 here into this function, you will get A plus by 3 is equal to 1. So here A plus by, because of B is equal to 3 plus by 3 is equal to 1. In other words, A is equal to negative 2. So now we have A is equal to negative 2 and B is equal to 3. So if you substitute into this function, the original function here, so my a here is equal to 3 divided by x minus 1 dx. So this is quite easy to solve. So the integration of over x plus 2 negative 2 over x plus 2 is a negative 2 log exponent x plus 2 plus by 3 log exponent x minus 1 plus by c. This is how we solve integration by parts. Integration integration using partial fraction technique. Okay, I have one more example here. Now let's say I have here x squared plus by 2, want to integrate x squared plus 2 over x raised 3 minus x. So x squared plus 2 over x raised 3 over x minus x, want to integrate this function. So because of here involving partial fraction, we have to convert in terms of we factorize the below function here. So we can write here as a x squared plus by 2 over, so x multiplied by x squared minus by 1 dx. If you multiply again, you get x raised 3 minus by x. And this one can be written as x squared plus 2 over x minus 1 x plus 1 dx. Because of x squared minus by 1 is x minus 1 x plus by 1. Okay, now if I use the partial fraction technique, this can be written as integration of a over x, the first factor, plus by b over x minus 1 plus by c over x plus 1. So I have 3 here, 3 fraction here, dx. Okay, now you can easily solve this one because of the basic rule of 1 over x is log exponent x. So log exponent x. So here we come. The answer here is a log exponent x plus by the integration of b over x minus 1 is b log exponent x minus 1 plus by c log exponent x plus 1 plus by c. This is the answer for the situation. But the problem here is we need to find a, b, and c. Okay, you need to find a, b, and c. And to find a and b and c, you can refer to the previous example. So I have here a over x plus b over x minus 1 plus by c over x. That's this one. We cannot put d here because put c here d. So c over x plus 1. Then this is equal to the original function. That is the numerator is x squared plus by 2. X squared. You have to compare with x squared plus by 2. Compare to the numerator. Okay, now. To find a and b here, we equate this function. So this one can be written as, so just now we have two fraction a and b. Now we have 3 fractions. So every of each here we multiply by the denominator for the other fraction. So for this one a, we need to multiply by this one and this thing. So A multiplied by x minus 1 multiplied by x plus 1. Whereas B, for B, for B, we need to multiply by the other fraction is B multiply by X. B, we multiply by X and multiply by X plus 1. So B multiply by X and X plus 1. Multiply by X and X plus 1. While C plus by C, you need to multiply by X. C multiply by X. And x minus by 1. And this is equal to x squared plus by 2. Now, if I solve this one, I'll get, so a, here is x minus x, multiplied by x plus 1, either x minus 1 multiplied by x plus 1 is equal to x squared minus by 1 plus by and bx multiplied by x is bx squared plus by bx plus by cx squared minus by cx is equal to x squared plus by 2. So if I open this bracket, we have a x squared minus by a plus by b x squared plus by b x plus by c x squared minus by c x equal to x squared plus by 0x plus by 2. 0x is 0. Then I have to cluster this part, so I have to cluster this one. So I put here together x squared and x squared I put all together. So a x squared plus by b x squared plus by c x squared. Then I put b x and x plus by b x minus by c x. Then the last one is minus by a equal to x squared plus by 0x, 0 plus by 2. So this one can be written as x squared. All the common factor here is x squared. So I have a x squared here, x squared a plus b plus c plus by. And for this case, the common factor here is x. So x b minus by c. And here you put just put a here, you mean here. So x squared plus by, or in other words, you can put x squared multiplied by 1 plus by 0x, or you can put here x multiplied by 0x plus by 2. So x 0x or x multiplied by 0 plus by 2. Now if you compare this one, so in other words, a plus b plus c is equal to 1, b minus c is equal to 0, negative a is equal to 2. So in other words, we have negative a is equal to 2, or a is equal to negative 2. This part we got one only, so a is equal to negative 2. The first one, we got a is equal to negative 2. Now, x b minus c, so here if you compare x and x here, so b minus c here, b minus c is equal to 0, okay, and a plus b plus c is equal to 1. So a plus b plus c is equal to 1. So from the above we know that a is equal to negative 2, so I just substitute here. So b minus c is equal to 0. Let's say I put here number 1. I know that a is equal to negative 2. I put here negative 2. A is equal to negative 2 plus b plus c is equal to 1. Okay. In other words, here become B plus C become, if you put, you bring to the right here, B plus C is equal to 3. So B plus C is equal to 3. So if I solve this one, if I add this together, negative C plus by C is equal to 0, B plus B is 2B, 0 plus 3 is equal to 3. So 2B plus 0 or 2B is equal to 3. In other words, B is equal to 3 over 2. So we got A negative 2 and B is equal to 3 over 2. And from here, we can get C. So we know that A plus B plus C equal to 1. So which is A is negative 2 plus by B is 3 over 2 plus by C is equal to 1. And from here, C, we get C is equal to 1, 3 minus by 3 over 2. So 3 minus by 3 over 2 is 3 minus by, here is negative 4 over 2 plus by 3 over 2 is equal to negative 1 over 2. Negative 1 over 2, 1 plus by 1 plus 1 plus 1 over 2 is 1 plus 1 over 2 is 3 over C is equal to 3 over 2. So C is also equal to 3 over 2. Okay, now we have A is negative 2, B is 3 over 2, and C is 3 over 2. Then you can substitute into the previous function, the original function just now. I have the integration of so I have, first of all, we have the integration of x squared plus 2, x is 3 over x is x. I convert into partial fraction technique. I convert to partial fraction. I have here x squared plus 2 over x minus 1, x plus 1, dx. This I got a over x plus by b over x minus 1 plus by c over x plus 1 dx. And then from here, we use several techniques. Just now, we got our a is negative 2. So the integration here, if we integrate here, we get a log exponent x plus by b log exponent x minus 1 plus by c log exponent x plus 1 plus by d. So I substitute here as a as a negative 2, so I put here negative 2 log x, b is equal to 3 over 2 log exponent x minus 1, and c is also 3 over 2 log exponent plus by 1 plus by d. This is the final answer for the integration just now. Okay, this is known as a partial fraction technique. Okay, now I have a few questions here, so you can use this one as a assignment, the third assignment. Your third assignment is, I have a few questions here. So first one, you can use I want you to use integration by parts, okay? Integration by part techniques. Okay. So the first assignment here, the first group of questions here. The first one is use integration. These are assignment. It's a group assignment. Group assignment number 3. So this integration by part, eh? Integration by part. So I want you to integrate this one. So first one is integrate x raised 3 cos x raised 4 plus by 2 dx. 2. This does not mean you need to put x, u is equal to x raised 3. You can be x raised 4 plus by 2, depending how you solve this problem. So the second one is I have 2x here. So square root of multiplied by square root of 2x multiplied by square root of 1 plus by x squared dx. Okay, 1 plus by x squared dx. Number 3, I want you to integrate x over square root of 1 minus by 4x squared dx. 4x squared dx. Number 4, the integration of cos 5x dx. And the last one is the integration of square root of 1 plus by x squared multiplied by x raised 5. x raised 5 dx. So this is integration by part, solve using integration by part. And the other one is fraction, partial fraction technique. So integration using partial fraction. So by using the partial fraction, and there's a question here. So number 1, so I want you to integrate I have more one question here. So question number six here is you need to integrate x squared e raised x dx. Okay. So the other part is integration using partial fraction technique. I want you to integrate x raised 2 plus by 2x minus by 2x raised 3 plus by 3x raised 2 minus by 2x dx. Then the second one, I want you to integrate the integration of 2x squared minus by x plus by 4 over x raised 3 plus by dx. So please integrate this one, and please submit to me through my guru before 3 is 9 with 20th of January. So we have group assignment 3, and then previously I have given you assignment 1 and assignment 2. So these are two set of questions, A and B. Okay. That's all for the questions, and I'll still see you next week. And don't forget that our test, we have a test this week, so just prepare for the test. Now, the same assignment here is please submit the form 18th of July, okay? It's not 20th of July, 18th of July. 18th of July. Before 18th of July, okay. So that's all for today. So okay, see you next week. This is a week 11 lecture. Thank you very much. Yeah.